So, I got the MRI improved, and I got the MRI done last week, and it showed some significant issues with my lumbar and my cervical spine. I didn't realize that. It's called that for guys as well as girls, it's, makes sense. The pelvis is slightly different for guys and girls. So, it makes sense that they call the, the cervical, the lower in below the lumbar is the cervical spine. Is there's several. I have issues with the lower two, L4 and L4, L5. Of the lumbar, and I also found out that I have issues with the I forget what numbers they are. It's the lower two of the cervical spine. So, basically, I found out I'm gonna have to have surgery, and I don't know when. So they're talking January before I get even a doctor's appointment to talk to the doctor about my options. So it's it's good that it means that or at least I take it to mean it isn't something that they're afraid of something happening right now. So it's not an emergency. So on Monday, I'm going into the doctor And they're going to do another spinal injection. This, they do the lumbar. I don't know if it's puncture or it's, it basically is puncture. Because they're going in with a needle. And they go into they shoot anesthetic and steroids into my spine. Because the problem I've been having is the spinal canal is basically the bone that goes around the spinal cord. You know, it's narrowing, or it has narrowed, and there's a certain amount of wiggle room for a normal spine, and basically, because my spine narrows around my spinal cord. It's not clamping it off. It's preventing it from moving freely. And that causes pain and, you know, certain stiffness and those issues. So basically that's what's going on. So basically it's a lot of frustrating hurry up and wait for in between next appointment and different therapies for I'm doing physical therapy. I've been doing it all along. Man, even if I think I couldn't get any scheduled, I had, you know, was doing exorcism myself. So I don't know what to say, but say a prayer or what good thoughts, whatever you do, here's hoping that, you know, this is I don't want to be a fatalist, but It's hard to be a fatalist when you've died twice. But I'm, you know, it's I don't mind doctors and the hospital. It's when they don't have answers. That's what scares me. And I'm not sure if that's Asperger's or if that's a normal human condition or so. I'll see you guys later.